Before proceeding, don't forget to click on that subscribe button to join our little family.
And also click on that bell button so that you get notified as soon as we upload a new video.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So today we're gonna show you that how you can convert your old sari into box fitted skirt.
Can you hear my heartbeat calling? Can you feel the love we're falling? Just take my hand and take me home tonight. Throwing caution to the wind, I'll take a chance and let you.
You can wear this skirt with crop top, or if you don't like crop top, you can go with full sleeve white t-shirts as well. You can wear this skirt for the upcoming wedding season and for casual wear as well if you use some casual sari. Since we love you guys a lot and we would like to appreciate your love and support by introducing a new feature to our channel, which is
featuring a couple of you guys on our channel from upcoming videos.
And to get featured, all you have to do is turn your notifications on, which is the bell button right beside the subscribe button, and comment down below that you have turned your notifications on so that we can select a couple of you and feature you in our videos. So let's get into our tutorial.
For this, you're gonna need a sari of stiff material if possible, a petticoat to go under it, invisible or concealer zipper, and a chalk. To begin with, I'm cutting off this brown piece from my sari. You can skip this step if you don't have such border. Now, lay your sari flat, right side up, and take out your ruler or measuring tape and mark 1 inch point from the edge. Now, this will be our seam allowance. Now, from this point, mark a 4 inch gap, then place your measuring tape at your recent mark and then make a 4 inch mark again. Now, so basically, we are just making 4 inch marks along the sari length and not the sari breadth. Now keep on doing it until you reach to 10 to 15 marked points. Now for the box pleats, pick the sari from the second point and bring it to the first point like shown and pin it in place. Then take the third marked point and then place it to the fourth point, making a complete box pleat. So you have one box pleat done. Now from the back it should look something like this. Now then do the same process again, take the next upcoming point, bring it to the previous point, then pin it in place, and then take the next point and take to the upcoming point, and keep on doing it until you create sufficient pleats. Once done, take your measuring tape and measure the pleats horizontally, leaving the initial 1 inch gap, and see if the pleat length is equal to your waist length. Then take 1 inch extra and cut a straight line. Now stitch the pleats in place via basic stitch. Once done, keep it aside, take the remaining piece of the sari, in our case it's pallu, and cut 6.5 to 7 inch broad rectangular piece whose length should be equal to your waist size plus 2 inch for seam allowance. Now this is the waistband, and to seal the fraying edges, do a zigzag stitch over it, but you can skip this step as well if you want. Now take your petticoat, cut its waistband out and also rip it open from one side. so that you can attach it to the skirt. Now to attach it to the skirt, place the petticoat to the inside part of your skirt and make some pleats while you stitch. Now if your petticoat is broader than your waist side, then only you need to make pleats. Once done, it should look something like this. Now moving on to your waistband, take the waistband of your petticoat, rip it open so that you get a broad piece, and then place it to the inside part of your skirt waistband. Now to stitch the waistband to the skirt, place both the right sides of the skirt and the waistband together and stitch a basic stitch on the edge of your skirt so that when you flip it, you get something like this. Then moving on to the final step, that is zipper installation. Bring the sides of the skirt together, that is wrong side out, and pin it in place from the waistband seam. Now fold your waistband into half like shown and place your zipper top end to the center of the fold and pin some points, mark points both at the beginning and where the zipper ends. Here I've used marking pins to make my points. Now stitch a very light stitch from the first marked point to the second so that you can rip it open later on. Now open up your zipper and then start pinning it wrong side up on the seam line of the very light stitch we made. Keep on pinning it until you have placed the entire zipper onto the seam line. Stitch it in place and then pull the zipper end out and start stitching from just above the end of the zipper to the end of the skirt to finish. And then open the light stitch we made so that we can see the zipper placement. Now this is our final step. Fold the edge of the waistband a little bit inside and then fold it into half to cover the zipper like this. And then stitch over it. Do the same thing on the other band. And then if you have any extra waistband like I do, cut it a bit and then stitch the opening of the waistband right on top where the waistband and the skirt seam meets so that there won't be any stitching visible from the outside. And that's it, we're done.
Subscribe button so that you don't miss any notification from our videos. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.